कर्मसु युक्त
स्वप्न
ends content, sukha, art of loving, art of living, all these things which facilitates, that is yoga. That is food, yogic food. So this is, first of all, this we must follow. You cannot go. That is called kama chara, kama vada, kama bhakshana. Three are the worst kind of sins we human beings commit deliberately. Animals don't do that. We do that. Knowingly we do it. Prasya, Stigha, Dhritya, Nama. All these are qualities of that food items not at all mentioned. So all is sattva bala arogya sukha priti. That type of food we first start. Then vihara. What is that vihara? Vihara means not walking here and there. Daily programs from dawn to dusk. It is started from Brahma Muhurta. Why is that Brahma Muhurta? It is prayer to the sunrise. 48 minutes prayer. Suryodaya ke pehle, 48 minutes ke pehle, ek shubh muhurt hai. It is called Brahma. First of all, the whole day starts with amrita muhurt. According to Hindu system, Vedic system of daily program, it is not that Suryodaya is the first starting point of that particular day. No, amrita muhurta. Pakka amrita, every muhurta comprises 48 minutes. Amrita muhurta starts before three units of muhurtas. Amrita muhurta, Vishnu muhurta, Brahma muhurta, Dhyuma Dhyuti muhurta. Then the sun rises. That is the system. This is our vijnana, jyotir vijnana, Vedic science. It gives this type of very good guideline to us, all yogis, all yoga practitioners. So, amrita muhurta, you have to take up. If not possible, brahma muhurta, that means 4:45 a.m. That will be more or less starting time of that muhurta. It will continue for 48 minutes. Muhurta means 48 minutes unit. Every 24 hours daily cycle comprises 24 hours, 30 muhurtas. This understanding must be there for all yoga practitioners so that before that Brahma Muhurta, you must start. Sit. Don't lay down. Even sit somewhere. Not within the four walls built by concrete. Somewhere in some huts, hermitages, in woods. There you have to sit. Or you have to walk. So that our upper chamber of human body, comprising 101 nadis, will get activated. As soon as it is activated, our upper chamber acts like an antenna. Antenna to suck solar and lunar cosmic energies. That is what in our scientific terminology we call it ozone. Ozone. In the Vedic terminology it is called Soma Surya Sakshatkar. So that our body acts like an antenna, so that through those, this Brahmarandhra, Soma Surya rays will be percolating in every limbs and all 72,000 nadis. So that is the real yoga. Early in the morning, just sitting, and upper chamber gets activated. Whole pranamaya kosha comprising 72,000. smaller nadis gets activated. Wonderful yoga it is. Real internal snana, antasnana, internal bathing. It is not only for external swachhata. We use all those soaps and made up of chemicals and all this. That is not real bath taking. This is real bath taking. Vital sheet. Pranamaya kosha. This we have to start. With this we have to start. That is called vihara. Once this becomes the real beginning of our journey to that particular day, the yoga's first lesson will start, commence. So ahara, vihara. Then vyavahara, brief time putting forth these thought processes. Vyavahara means it is with how many, whatever people we mingle, we talk to them, where we walk and talk where, and what type of ambience we created around our houses, what type of lodging boarding we use for our stay, what type of clothing you prefer. All such things become vyavaharya. There we have problems, because every item, whatever we wear, whatever ornaments we use, whatever footwear and all those things we use, made up of petroleum, made up of iron, which is not at all good for human body. It will be affecting the whole system, our whole body system, even blood circulation system will be affected. That type of things we are accustomed to do that. We never walk barefooted. Every time we use that something made of petroleum, it is very much bad to the whole human anatomy and physiology, psychology, everything. That will be hard to give up. That is called vihara. Yukta ahara, vihara, vyavahara. Then two more, swapna avabodha. Swapna avabodha. How much we have to be awakened, where we have to sleep, at what time we have to sleep, that is very, very important. That is called eco-friendly evening, eco-friendly morning. As soon as the sun sets, we have to stop eating, actually. Now, late night supper becoming so much glamour. All young people, they start eating and talking through mobile, eating late night. These are all against the yoga way of life. Doing all these things just half an hour, 1 hour in asana pranayama? No. It is against this mantra. Yukta swapna avabodha. So as soon as it is Brahma Muhurta, you cannot lay down on your bed. You have to stand, you have to walk, you have to sit, first of all. Then you must go for proper sadhya food. Then you are wearing, you are staying, lodging, boarding, everything must be eco-friendly. It must be made up of wood and mud, not made up of your concrete and your plastics and all these things. They are not at all friendly to human nature, human psychology and physiology. All this understanding must be there. That is the real mantra. This mantra is not telling anything. Asana, pranayama, pratyahara, dharana, dhyana, samadhi, all these very great practices of sadhya yoga. It only deals with the very normal things. Your food, your day-to-day program, your lodging, boarding, and your dress and all this. And one important point, we must not wear anything made up of steel and petroleum. Any ornament, even your rings, your necklace, all such things must be made up of gold only, because our body is very much made up of sunrays. Upper layer of our body, human body, it sucks more and more solar energy So that we must have more golden ornaments. If at all you want to wear some ornament, it must be made up of gold. And below our stomach area, navel area, there must be any ornament made up. It must be silver, because Chandrama Soma content will be there in our lower region of the body. That is how these understandings are very much important. With this understanding only we can go for ahara, vihara, vyavahara, and sopna and avabodha. Sopna means dream, sleep actually, avabodha means awakening. With this understanding, we must go for 21st Global International Yoga Day. Again, please repeat the sloka here. Please sit properly again. Again and again, you are sitting properly. Yukta Hara Viharasya.
Yukta
Hara Viharasya. Chapter number 6, Shloka number 1720.